Okay, good. That's good.
You look very sunny for a Sunday.
Thank you. It's been good. I got it. You know, I took a 10:30 train in from LA. I got in there around 2. So far, so good. It's been this.
Okay, tell us everything.
Yes.
What secrets do you want to know?
Okay, well, one, what is the big mystery of this season? So we saw the flash forward, which also loved that finale.
Yeah, good. It was, it was a really ambitious finale. It was tricky because most of it was set outdoors. Everyone was exhausted. It was night shoots. It was still freezing in Vancouver. And it was a really, really intense. And you know, really honestly, we were still, I think, reeling from the passing of Luke. So it was sort of like, but everyone kind of held together and came together. The flash forward's fun. That is one of our big mysteries. The night of the flash forward kind of hits around halfway through the season. So building up to it, we'll see different glimpses. We'll do different flash forwards, one every episode that kind of fill in the night of and the immediate aftermath. And then there'll be the night. And then on the second half of the season, we'll see kind of like the ramifications and the fallout from that. But it's I would say that the mystery this year, or the threat this year, is a little bit more, you know, we've done serial killers, we've done mafia stories, we've done hard crime. I would say that this year it's a little bit more suspense. It's a little more like the films of Alfred Hitchcock, you know, like Strangers on a Train and Rope, which is one of my favorites. It's a little bit like the crime novels of Patricia Highsmith. So there's a talented Mr. Ripley aspect to it. And then one of my favorite suspense novels is Donna Tartt's The Secret History, which is a wonderful book. But that's about a kind of a group of students at an elite college, and a murder happens, and then there's a cover-up, and it kind of, the group unravels. So those are kind of like the touchstones for this year. But I will say it's the mystery is definitely a slower burn this year by design, so that we could kind of focus more on emotional storytelling and character storytelling, and honestly, high school. Like, this is it. It's like, and it's so funny, when we started in the room, you know, I'm a big believer in, like, if you introduce the speakeasy, you do a lot of stories at the speakeasy, and if you introduce boxing, like, we do boxing stories. And when we were kind of gathering, I said, guys, this is it for high school. Like, this is it. If we're doing a high school story, if you've ever wanted to do high school, it's this year or bust. So we're really leaning into that, and it's been really fun. Bittersweet, too. You know, I think senior year, everyone has different experiences in high school, but I do think you have this awareness, like, oh, the next part of my life is about to start. And on the one hand, you can't wait for it to start. And on the other hand, you don't want to say goodbye to your friends. And there's a certain comfort in that. You know, I know when I started high school, I did not fit in. And I'd come home and I, like, would go to my room and I would cry and stuff. And then when I was graduating, I was crying because I didn't want to say goodbye to my friends. So it's that bittersweet vibe, I think, is kind of hanging over the season. Also, you know, it's funny, Archie Comics has always been defined by high school. So it's like, it's you do kind of like think, like, you know, what does happen after graduation and senior prom and stuff. Yeah.
And then also you have two schools, right?
I do one.
So there's some second school, obviously.
Yes.
So can you say a bit more about Jughead?
Yeah. So, you know, we, season 2, introduced Southside High, and that was a really great franchise for us. You know, we met Tony Topaz, we met Fangs Fogarty, we met Sweet Pea, and it was really, really great. And we kind of got to see, you know, a school on the wrong side of the tracks, a school that had kind of been overrun by gangs and things like that. We're kind of going in the opposite direction this year. Is we're creating a prep school, Stonewall Prep, that are going to be our big rivals with Riverdale High. So we're going to see a big football game between Riverdale High and the Stonewall Prep, the Stonewall Stags, excuse me. And we're going to see, you know, I love movies like Dead Poets Society and School Ties. So those are also touchstones for this year. I also want to say, though, even though Jughead goes there, he will absolutely still be having scenes with Betty and Archie and all that stuff, and it is out of town, but only just out of town.
So is he gonna have to wear like a school uniform?
He's gonna have to wear a blazer and tie. I know.
But with the beanies still.
Yeah. Yeah. Who knows?
He'll make it cool.
Yeah.
Coming soon in a hot
dog. Yeah.
Topic.
They'll make his hat. Well, they can make him take his hat off. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.